أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله In the name of Allah سبحانه وتعالى We send peace and blessings upon the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم His household, his companions, may Allah سبحانه وتعالى bless them and bless each and every single one of us. Amen. May Allah سبحانه وتعالى strengthen us. May Allah سبحانه وتعالى bless our families, the children, the spouses, those who want to get married. May Allah grant them the best of spouses, those who are already married. May Allah bless them, the spouses, the families, and the children. Ameen. From the dua I made, we should already know what I would love to talk about, inshallah. So inshallah, I'd like to address and say a few pointers about marriage and a few pointers about the living or the life that we live with the spouses and the life that we live with the children. The responsibilities, some of the responsibilities that are there and some of the things a father is supposed to do and not do or a mother is supposed to do and not do, coupled with what's happening today across the globe with the social media and so many challenges that the parents are facing when it comes to, let's get to it, inshallah. So marriage, we know, is a great act of worship for a believer. A great act of worship that a person gets to a point when they want to get married and inshallah they try their best to get the best of spouses. And when they do so, they pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses the union and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses the family and whatever will come after or in or as a result of the union or as a result of the marriage. If you look at the verse that says, رَبَّنَا هَبْ لَنَا مِنْ أَزْوَاجِنَا وَذُرِّيَّاتِنَا قُرَّةَ أَعْيُنْ وَجَعَلْنَا لِلْمُتَّقِينَ إِمَامًا Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, رَبَّنَا هَبْ لَنَا مِنْ أَزْوَاجِنَا وَذُرِّيَّاتِنَا قُرَّةَ أَعْيُنْ O our Lord, grant us from our spouses and our offspring. You know, رَبَّنَا هَبْ لَنَا مِنْ أَزْوَاجِنَا وَذُرِّيَّاتِنَا قُرَّةَ أَعْيُنْ Grant us spouses and offspring that will be the coolness of our eyes. وَجَعَلْنَا لِلْمُتَّقِينَ إِمَامًا And make us an example for... Make us good example for the believers or for the righteous. Make us, for the righteous, good example. So this is a powerful dua. Everyone wants a good offspring. Everyone wants a good offspring. Yes, good family, good children, and all this, we make these du'as. But then when we look at what is there, we have to understand that marriage is actually a responsibility. It's not about getting married and just wanting to get married and satisfying your desire by doing what you do and you have children and your only goal, your only aim is to just keep having children and to keep giving birth. You are not bothered about whatever comes thereafter. The responsibility you are supposed to take, the responsibilities that are there are much. You don't know about them or you know about them but you don't care because from the beginning that was not your concern. You didn't look at it as an act of worship. You did not look at it as an act of worship. You did not look at it as an ibadah, as something that you would do throughout your life till you die, because you would be married to your wife until you leave this earth. And inshallah, in Jannah as well, you meet and take it from there. But a lot of us don't think, a lot of people don't think about it like that. The only thing is, you know what? I've gotten to a point, I want to satisfy. I want to just get married and I'll just give birth and keep giving birth and birth and birth and birth. And that's the only thing. No. It comes with so much duty, so much responsibilities. You have to take care of your children. You have to ensure that your children learn about the deen. You have to ensure that you bring up children who are righteous, children that the ummah will be proud of. How is that going to come? Primarily, in fact, by ensuring that the wife you marry, the mother of your children, is the best one. So what do you go for? The looks or the lineage of the girl? Or their wealth? No. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "Fasfar bidhat dini tarbat yadak." You know, save yourself when it comes to the selection of a spouse by making the deen the most significant factor you look at. Fasfar bidhat dini tarbat yadak. Wow. Not bidhatil mal or bidhati, you know, jamal. No. Deen, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, because she can be the most beautiful, she can be from the most wealthy house, but if the deen is not there, there is a big problem, because the mother of your children that is supposed to spend time with them and inshallah make them become, grow up to have good upbringing, is already bad. So where do you start from? So that's why it's important, even the wife, ensure you get the best of spouses. That's why the Prophet said, "Fasfar bidhati dini tarbatidak." We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the best of spouses. So now you marry, mashallah, you've got the best one. It's not bad to have a beautiful wife. It's not, meaning everyone wants, didn't you pray, "Rabbana hablana min azwajina wa dhiriyatina qurrata ayun." Yes, the one you look at and you're, wow, mashallah, happy, alhamdulillah, that's good. But the only thing we are saying is, don't allow the others fulfilled and one is missing. What? There is Jamal, there is Mal, and there are so many other things, but Deen out, then there is a problem. But ensure there is Deen, there is Jamal, there is Mal, and there is Khuluq, Akhlaq, and so many things are there. And it's good. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Idha ataakum man tardawna deenahu wa khuluquhu fazawwijuhu." If a proposal has come to you and you are satisfied with the deen and the character of that person, then let the marriage happen. Yes, let the marriage happen. The Prophet said what? Satisfied with the deen and the character, not satisfied with the wealth or the facial looks. So it's important. Now let's get into it. Now you marry, mashallah. Deen, Jamal, maybe Mal, Akhlaq, everything good, set. Now you would begin to have children. That is the next duty, the next step, which you have to take responsibility of. When you give birth, that is an amana from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those children are an amana from Allah. You must spend time with them. You must take care of them. You must ensure you look for good schools for them. Secular, religious, everything set. You must spend time with them. You must fulfill their rights. You must do what Allah has told you to do when it comes to the children. Ensure everything is good. You don't do just what you want, but you say, what has Allah said? When I give birth, what should I do with the child, the son or the daughter? Ensure you bring them up in the best way. You bring them up in the best way, mashallah. They have deen, they have good secular education. When you come to the secular, a lot of us don't really care about the deen, you know. What is my son learning in the madrasa? Nobody cares. But when it comes to the secular, now your son says, or daughter, for example, "I want to learn or study something that has to do with the deen." And you say, no, no ways. You must be a doctor, an engineer, or a lawyer. No. Allah doesn't say the path for Jannah is for you to become a lawyer or an engineer or a doctor. No. No. So let your child study what they want to study. That is also one of the duties you're supposed to fulfill. Because Allah didn't say that you must force your child to study what they don't want to study. At the end of the day, as a result of you forcing them to study what they don't want to study, they now want to cut out their link with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They now want to cut out their ibadah, because now they are depressed, they are unhappy, they don't want to have anything to do with the Quran anymore, they don't want to pray their salah anymore, they're just depressed. How can I convince my dad or my mom that I want to become a lawyer? Wow. Subhanallah, what did you cause? You've caused a disaster. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us an understanding. So allow your child to study what they want to study. When it comes to the deen, take them to the best Islamic school. It's absolutely important. Where they learn the deen and they grow up and they become good children that the ummah will be proud of. People usually use this hadith to justify giving birth and giving birth and giving birth without really bothering about would they be able to take care of the children that they give birth to, or they just want to give birth. What hadith? The hadith of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam that says, yes, tazawwaju al-wadud al-walud fa inni mubahim bikum al-umama yawm al-qiyamah. So people think, you know what? I just have to keep giving birth. One children, two, three, four, five, ten. I don't care. I cannot, even if I cannot cater for them, take care of them, people don't care. I just want to give birth. I want the ummah of the Prophet to increase. No. The Prophet will not be proud of you on the day of judgment having given birth to 10 children and all of them grew up as thugs. Why? You didn't take charge. You don't even care. You see children, they're out there. The father is focused, is in an entire world, entirely different. The children are also in another world that is different. Their way is not even the same. The father is to the left, the children are to the right. You ask the father, he doesn't even know what the children are up to. He doesn't care really. For as long as he gives food, that is if you are even lucky that he provides food. Some they don't even provide the food. Is that what Allah said? Is that what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said? No. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu qu anfusakum wa ahlikum nara. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, oh, you who believe, save yourselves and your families from the fire. Save yourselves and your families from the fire. Subhanallah. You're not saving yourself. You're doing things heading towards that direction. And as a result of your attitude and what you are doing, your children are also heading towards that direction. No, that is not what Allah said. Allah said, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu qu anfusakum wa ahlikum nara. So we have to understand these things. Life is very simple. You want to get married, mashallah, go learn what marriage is all about, the sunnah, what you're supposed to do, what you're not supposed to do, and the children, how are you going to take care of them? And mashallah, one, two, three children, it's okay, you're happy. And very important, when you come to marry, it's not a competition. Your marriage must not be the top in the city. Your marriage must not be the most spoken about. Your marriage must not be the most talked about. You know what? Brother Ibrahim and Sister Aisha, when the marriage happened, the marriage, the dinner took place in the top hotel. Where is the top hotel in Abuja? Transcorp Hilton. That's where the dinner took place. And everyone is talking. They paid millions of naira for the event. And every haram took place. And 1, 2, 3 months, marriage is broken. Wow. Maintain, nobody says, we're not saying don't celebrate completely. Even if you want to do anything, make sure it is halal within the limits of Allah. Don't transgress Allah. You want to start off something that is your future, 1, 2, 10, 20 years, a generation, the basic, the foundation, the basis of it, you started it in the displeasure of Allah. What type of offspring would you want to come from that type of union, marriage, for example? So it's important. Let's not deceive ourselves. Allah is Ghafoor Ar-Rahim. You know, it's okay. I'll do it and I will just seek forgiveness. Yeah, Allah is Ghafoor Ar-Rahim, but no. Do what is right. Do what is right. Just be happy. Do what, live your life according to what Allah has allowed you. Don't compete with the people. People cannot afford. They want to go and take loans. Taking loan, marriage happened with the loan money. They haven't even finished repaying the loan. The marriage is broken. What type of disaster is that? What's happening to us? We can improve by the will of Allah. We just have to try. Marriage is an act of worship. It's not a competition. It's not about competing on the social media. Who has the best couple pictures on the social media? Instagram, mashallah. You see the wives kissing and doing all. It's becoming dirtier and dirtier, filthier and filthier and filthier. And you're just thinking, what is really happening? A lot of these things happening, in fact, on the social media. Sometimes when you go to the house, it's not happening. The dad, the husband is there, the wife is there. They don't even talk to each other. But, you know, the first 2 weeks of the marriage or before marriage, they call it pre-wedding pics, etc. Everything, they're trying to make it look good. And they're posting on the social media. And people are saying, wow, mashallah, what a beautiful marriage. Come to the house after 2 weeks, 1 month, see what's happening. Subhanallah. So it's not about social media. It's not about impressing anyone. It's about your happiness. It's about what you're supposed to do. Learn. Do what is right. Go and look at the life of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. خيركم خيركم لأهله وأنا خيركم لأهلي. The best from among you are those who are best to their spouses, and I am the best from among you to my own spouse. That is what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. Look how he treated his spouses. Aisha radiallahu anha, how he lived with her in a beautiful way. It's amazing. Things that we can't even do. We don't, now life has become such because of the internet and the media. We don't want to take time to do things. Take time in the marriage and make it look like an ibadah. Everything is quick, quick, sharp, sharp, you know. all the sunnah lost. We are not following. Everything is quick, sharp, what is trending, and that's all. It's not about what is trending, it's about what is right and what is wrong. It's about what is right and what is wrong. And believe you, mean, oh, when you the marriage happens and how you live your life with your husband and wife, your children will see and they will think that is how they are supposed to treat the spouses when they marry. I saw a video on the internet, so two children were acting, mom and dad. So I think it's a brother and sister, they were acting. You know how the parents behave when they live in the house. So the small girl was there and her little brother was there. So they're just acting how mom and dad does. So the little brother was standing there, you know. No, the small sister was standing, and then they started acting. The brother came in and he acted how his father acts. He came with the bag from work, and he came in, and when he came in, he started frowning. Next thing, he slapped the little sister. What are they doing? They are acting how dad does to mom when he comes back from work. Life example, how you treat them is how they would think is the correct way for them to treat their spouses when they marry. No, go and look at the life of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's a home of beautiful relationship. Don't let the television take over. The time you are supposed to spend with your son and the daughter, your son and daughter is or are spending the time with the TV. Are the TV or is the TV now the parents or are you the parents? It's so bad. Look at the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When Aisha radiallahu anha would take something from the cup, he would pick the cup, he would turn it to where she had put her mouth on, where she had drank from, and he would drink from the same place, and she looks at him and mashallah, it's beautiful. What do we do today? What do we do today? The spoon your wife used to eat, no, I can't eat with that, it's dirty. Wash it so many times, I can't eat with it because it's dirty. What's that? Subhanallah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really to grant us an understanding and make us understand that marriage is an ibadah. It is an act of worship. It is not a competition. Make your children's life easy. I keep receiving so many emails and messages. It's either the husband is not doing what he's supposed to do with the wife. He's gone, he hasn't divorced the wife, but he's gone and he has allowed the wife with the children and he doesn't care. And sometimes they could say it's black magic, for example. It's sihir. It could be sihir, it could not be. It could be your husband is just bad. That's the truth. There's no sihir there. And it could be sihir. It could be. And then when comes the children complaining, my parents are making my life difficult. I want to get married. I've got a spouse, but they say no. Allow your child to marry. What is there? What is it? Make life simple and easy. Very simple. Make it very easy. Subhanallah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us an understanding. Your children want to study something, allow them. Your children want to marry, let it be. Let them marry who they want to marry. For as long as إِذَا أَتَاكُمْ مَنْ تَرْدَوْنَ دِينَهُ وَخُلُقَهُ وَزَوِّجُهُ is fulfilled, is looked into, let the marriage happen. The money will come thereafter. A lot of the parents don't care about those things. They just care about who are you marrying? Whose child is he? Whose child is he? Wow, whose child is he? He's the son of the most richest, but I can tell you his character is bad. He doesn't have nothing to do with the deen. He probably marry her and keep beating her up in the house and relating with every other girl outside of the marriage. Is that what you want for your daughter? If that's what you want, go ahead. And see what Allah is going to do for you. Because Allah is definitely going to come for you. Allah won't let things go. Allah will come for you. If you don't want Allah to come for you, do what is right. Do what is right and there would be peace. You know, in fact, that hadith towards the ending, the Prophet ﷺ said, if you then don't allow the marriage happen after the deen and the akhlaq is good, there shall be fasad on the earth. And hence, fasad everywhere. Crisis, corruption everywhere. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us and strengthen us, grant us goodness in this world and the next. Marriage is an act of worship. Let's learn from the teachings, from the Quran, and from the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. ربنا هب لنا من ازواجنا وذرياتنا قرة اعين واجعلنا للمتقين اماما سبحانك اللهم ربنا وبحمدك اشهد ان لا اله الا انت استغفرك واتوب اليك والسلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته.